what kind of photography do you do? Like, do you have a certain, like, niche that you do?
I guess sort of, yeah, but I guess what I aim to photograph is anything that documents a feeling or a story. So a lot of the feelings that I'm currently relating to are motherhood and kids and things like that. But it could be like really anything. Like if you're out, even if I'm out in nature, if it catches a mood and a feeling, then, you know, I'll photograph it. But mainly families, kids, and anybody with a story.
I like that because then you can put a little bit of yourself into it, and you can also relate to your, you know, to your subjects. You understand when a mom's holding a child.
Right.
You understand like how important that is and how it's, well, I should show you, like I have my, I found a bunch of pictures in my wallet.
Mm-hmm.
I caught, just yesterday, and I put it on Instagram, but I've had these pictures for 15 years that have been in my wallet, the same ones, and they look terrible. But, you know, again, they're like, they're my son.
Right.
They're a picture of my son. And how important is that? So when you're taking these pictures, I'm pulling out, you know, these are, looks really good and actually on radio. No, but when you...
so there's a lot of them.
Yeah. No, but... Yeah,
they look very vintage.
See, like, look, you see, like, they're very vintage. They're very, like, totally, like, messed up.
Yeah.
Been in my wallet, but, yeah. But,
I love that.
But, like, you get to be a part of that, taking pictures of these families. Like, what a, like an heirloom? Or just like, you know, these families will remember that forever.
Right, right, right. That's what I hope. I hope to, you know, the feelings, whatever feeling it is, anger, happiness, love, whatever, they pass sometimes. But then when you bring it back, not that the feeling passes, you know what I mean? But like you forget because you go through your day-to-day activities and then you look back and you pick it up or you see it on your wall and you're like, oh, remember that? When it, and it brings you back and it takes you there.
Well, you think you're going to remember everything. Like, you know, I don't remember, and I'm showing her a picture of my son.
Yeah.
I do not remember what he, like, you know, what he felt like at that time. And now he's 17 years old. I'm not going to hold him like that.
No.
Yeah. So that's what's kind of hard to, like, you know.
So it's bringing you a feeling and a memory.
Yeah.
Feeling.
Exactly.
You're having a feeling.
So that's why I think it's so cool what you do.
Should we say that again?
Oh, I'm having a feeling. Yeah.
So I guess I document
feelings
more than no. Okay.
Well, no, we're working
breaking
on your,
into song.
Yeah, are we working on your like kind of tagline or something? That working on feelings.
No, I mean, you know, I was just kind of retweaking my website yesterday, and I was working with like a mentor because, you know, every day you need a mentor.
Yeah.
Right? But anywho, we were talking about that, and that's what kind of stuck. You know, so when you ask me what it is that I like to photograph, is really just a feeling.
Yeah.
It's very broad and very deep, you know, but
it's cool. You document feelings.
Yeah. And stories.
So how did this whole photography bug happen? Like, did you as a kid pick up a, you know, camera, like, hey, this is what I want to do? Like, how did it start?
Yeah, no, it started in high school.
Okay.
Way back. And it started with film.
5 years ago.
Right. It started in high school, and I started with film, and my family didn't have a lot of money, but we went to, you know, the pawn shop, and I picked up just whatever camera was there.
Yeah.
And so that's where I started to dork out in the dark room. And
just black and white.
Yeah. And they think I did some color, too. But yeah, and that's where it started, and then... I went off to college and I was a film studies major there.
Oh, cool.
And I would still have my camera, but film was more complicated, and I really thought that, okay, I just want to tell stories, right? I want to tell the narrative.
Yeah.
But then of course, you know, that industry is tricky. And so my life took me to Austin, and then I, lived in Austin for a while, and then I photographed some things there.
What years did you live in Austin?
2010? So 2008, 2004.
You know what?
I
think I was around that time too. I lived in Round Rock actually for two years.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. Then moved back here again. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Was it 2010? Yeah. We moved in 2010. No, I got married in 2010. And then my son was born in 13. So yeah, that sounds about right. Oh my gosh. The dates.
Funny.
I don't know. It's like,
no.
I can't remember what I did yesterday. So I'm sorry. Which is why I take pictures.
Yeah. No, that's good. No, as time goes by, I forget everything. Yeah.
So that's how it started. And then, you know, I had a baby. And then, like, most families, most humans. You just want to document the
everything.
The you know, out of them.
What's so funny about that is like when I when my first no, I have three kids. The first one was born. I don't have that many pictures. Now you have an iPhone.
Yeah.
It's like there's 30 pictures a day that come through there.
I know. Yeah.
But when you have, you know, I don't know, when I just, I it hurts to think about all the moments that I didn't take with him. And it was just 17 years ago. But now my 6-year-old, like, you know, again, 30 pictures over. My 11-year-old, 30 pictures over. My 17-year-old, he doesn't really want to be in camp pictures. So I don't, you know, he doesn't get on Instagram that much.
You know, and that's what's going to happen too. My two boys, I can already feel it. My 6-year-old, he's like,
okay.
You can't see that face, but every, you know, every time. And I remember when I first started photographing him, the silly things that I would put him in, you know, like the hat and the basket and all this like stuff and that. And then later in life, I found out that that was not what brought me joy. I liked him being messy and dirty.
it totally makes,
And the reality of that feeling of struggling to be a mom. Yeah. Tired, exhausted, and all that. And then that just evolves from there.
Okay, so if somebody wants to find out about your photography, they want to hire you, they want to, you know, learn more about like how you make these feelings or document these feelings and the song that you're going to start writing soon. Where do they go? What's your website?
It's leylakuhn.com. So it's leylakuhn.com. And I'm also on Instagram, and that's Leyla Kuhn Photography. Or I guess it's at.
They got that, yeah. No, that's where I follow. If you want to follow some really fun stories.
Riveting.
Yeah, riveting stories. I hear there's some story going to happen with lips that are, like duck lips that are glittered.
Right?
So yeah, that'll come out today. So, you know, you've been warned. Okay, great. Well, if you didn't get that website, we'll put it under on the video.
Go to eventsantacruz.com.
Yeah, thank you so much for being on the show. Okay, now we're going to...